Taste is a sense which is highly developed in humans. We are more sensitive than our canine and feline friends. We are not quite as good as herbivores. So why is this? Well, the sense of taste helps you discriminate what is good to eat and what is not. It can also clue you into the chemical makeup of the food. We know sweet foods are generally more energy dense, salty foods contain electrolytes, sour foods are usually acidic, and bitter can indicate harmful toxins. Umami flavors indicate amino acids are present in high quantity, such as in meats. Cats, which are obligate carnivores, cannot taste sweet stuff. Meat is meat, and while some animals are poisonous to consume, most creatures are largely edible. The feline sense of taste and smell are largely used as appetite stimulants. That's why cats love raunchy, smelly food. Side note, taste and smell are somewhat intertwined. The scent of a food will impact its taste. Dogs, which are more omnivorous, though not as much as humans, can taste sweet flavors since they include plant materials in their diet. Herbivores, which spend a lot of time eating plants which can look extremely similar, have very discriminatory palates. Plants want to avoid being eaten in most cases, so they develop toxins as a defense mechanism, since they cannot run away. So, herbivores must be able to distinguish plant species and detect which ones are toxic. The tongue is made up of several muscles working in conjunction. The upper surface of the tongue is covered in tiny, hair-like projections called papillae. Your taste buds, invisible to the unaided eye, are located on these papillae. Taste buds detect certain chemicals in your food. Nerves run near the surface of the tongue. When your taste bud binds to a chemical, it sends a message down one of these nerves to be relayed to your brain for interpretation. Then you can decide if you should continue eating that thing or not. The tongue is used for more than just tasting. It is also a part of the thermoregulatory system in some mammals. Dogs, for instance, will pant to cool down. We're going to talk about thermoregulation more in a little bit. Cat skulls are designed, like the rest of their body, to be an efficient murdering machine. Adult cats have a carnivore dentition pattern with 30 sharp, deep-rooted teeth. You can see here on this clear model of a cat jaw how deep those teeth roots go. This would be the bottom jaw. And this would be the top. You can see there's these deep roots in their teeth enable cats to use their teeth to catch, hang on to, and shred their prey to bits. If you think about an animal who's struggling for its life and trying to get away, it's going to put up quite a fight. So those teeth really need to be anchored in there solidly so that they don't get pulled out in the struggle. Incisors are the teeny tiny teeth in the front of a cat's mouth. They are used for grooming and nibbling bits of flesh from bone. Next would be the canines. These are designed to grip and hold prey. These are the teeth used to sink into flesh and hold struggling animals. Premolars have sharp edges used for shearing. There are 10 of these in the cat. Molars are flatter for grinding food. Cats only have 4 because molars are more useful for herbivorous and omnivorous diets. They are mostly used for processing plant material. The carnassial teeth consist of one upper premolar and one lower molar in the cat. These teeth fit together like a pair of scissors. They help shear apart pieces of meat. Kittens have 26 deciduous or baby teeth. They do not have molars since early in life they do not need them. Cats, dogs, people, and a lot of other mammals who only have 2 sets of teeth in their lifetime are known as diphyodonts. This means that they only have 2 sets of teeth in their lifetime. This is in contrast to the polyphyodont, an animal which has teeth which are continuously replaced throughout its lifetime. Examples of these types of animals would be reptiles and toothed fishes. Here's the tooth eruption timeline for kitties. As you can see, the different kinds of teeth erupt and are replaced at different times. Therefore, the growing kitten always has some teeth. If kitten lost all its teeth at once, this would be a serious disadvantage. Dogs have 42 adult teeth. Being more omnivorous than cats, they have a few extra teeth to help grind up plant material. Just like cats, dogs have 12 incisors for grooming and nibbling. They also have 4 canines to help grip and hold prey. In this example of a canine skull, you can see that the dog's teeth are also very deeply rooted, just like the cat's. This would be the lower jaw. There you can see the incisors, the canines. And this would be the upper jaw. Dogs have more premolars than cats. The shearing action helps tear apart meat and plant fibers. Plants are tougher to break down than flesh, so dogs have a few extra premolars to help them out with this task. They have 16 in total. The dog also has some more molars than a cat does. They've got a total of 10 molars used to help grind food particles. Again, this is an indication of their more omnivorous tendencies because plants are tough. Puppies are missing all the molars and 4 premolars compared to their adult set. Again, this is because puppies do not have to do a lot of chewing early on in life. As you can see, puppies also have staggered times to lose and gain different types of teeth.